promesas. Este es el pasaje que voy a traducir. The hour of the flood is there. Don't the flood, man. The presence of darkness. You are not someone who's going to encounter them because you have time to tell. This is the moment of truth. The time we've been waiting for. Father, send that the one that will make a difference in our life and mind did not cheat. Give us your sitting word that we turn our story around. Is there any black person here that has been seeing this sense? Let the name walk. Those who before change us and us, let them lay come around in this service in mind did not cheat. And before we pray for the spirit of wisdom, we pray for revelation knowledge. Let our eyes of understanding be enlightened as we walk from power in this sense. Good wisdom in our minds. Put understanding in our hearts. All to us in Jesus' precious name we have prayed.
Amen.
Let's give Jesus an applause and a shout of hallelujah. As you take your seat in heavenly places, say to your neighbor, your left and right, you are welcome to Living God Covenant Church. You'll be glad that you are in this circle because God is said to bless you and refresh you in Jesus' precious name.
Amen.
Arise, O Lord, unto the rest.
And give us peace round about.
And give us peace round about.
And
I fall into
thy grace.
Wonderful. That is our portion and our portion this year. Every one of us, we shall have peace round about. As I listened to those testifiers, the Lord said to me, He said, we should see every situation we find ourselves this year. All we need to do is to speak peace. Say, speak peace.
Speak peace.
You speak peace to that situation. It is what you say that God will do. If you say otherwise, God will do otherwise. It is what you want to see that you want to speak in your mind and not Jesus. Say, as you have said, unto my hearing, that is what I will do. So we must speak peace to all situations. Of course, we are in the last days, the perilous time, as was exemplified in the Bible. It was well stipulated in the Bible, 2 Timothy 1. He said, in the last day, the perilous times, all manners of things will be happening. Covetousness, truth breaker, covenant breaker, all manners of things. They will be signing all kinds of covenant things, anti-policies. Against our Lord Jesus Christ, all kinds of things. He said, then we should be patient. That those that truly that they are for, those that are godly, they will suffer what? Persecution. Once you are of God, you must suffer persecution. This is what it means. So we should not be afraid of tribulations, of persecutions, of what we hear that's happening. If things are not happening, then there is a problem. The prophecy of the Bible, which means the prophecy of God has not come to complete. Then when you are hearing all these kind of things that are, what kind of thing are you? You know that the prophecy has come to pass in the mind of the Lord Jesus. Then you will be strong in the Lord. When others are saying there is a blessing, what would you say?
There is a blessing.
When others are saying that there is war, what would you say?
It's peace.
It's peace. That is what he said. He told us this year that we are going to enjoy peace. Not just peace on one side, round about, 360 degrees. Peace on the north, peace on the south, peace on the west, peace on the east. Round about peace. That is what he has said. Once he has spoken twice, have I heard. So we must be very strong and be courageous. We must be strong and be courageous. We must still uphold the word of God. Faith is difficult. Faith is very difficult. And the enemy will fight you. They will fight your faith. The enemy will fight your faith. They know that are strong, you will be able to overcome the mind of the Lord Jesus. If you are strong and you are patient, you will overcome. And that's why the word of God let us know in Revelation 13, verse 10. Is it you that keep you one of my patient? I will keep them in the hour of temptation. That will try your work. So all of you have to be patient. You have to keep the word of God. What is the word of God saying? What is the word of God saying? That is what you want. What is the word of God saying? And tonight, we shall be learning coming kingdom. So that we're able to overcome the enemy. So this sermon is 761 for those who are in our series. And it is subtitled Overcoming the Enemies of Faith to Enter God's Rest. See how I'm
overcoming?
The enemies of faith to enter God's rest. Woo! Now, God has promised us rest. And what is rest? Rest is for us to cease from our work, for allow God to take over for us, to begin to do everything for us. Rest is to have peace. That is what rest is. For us to have peace on all sides. For us to be fruitful, for us to begin to multiply, for us to begin to enjoy the peace of God, and that's all understanding. Just as he said in John 14, verse 27, he said, my peace I leave with you. Not as the world gives you peace. He said, my peace I give to you. Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't let your heart be troubled. Don't be afraid. Because I'll be with you. Once God is with you, you are overcome. And God is with us in the mind of Jesus.
Amen.
Now, that's what I want to look at. Faith, when we talk of faith, faith is a spiritual force which we know that we use to take delivery of the promises of God. The promises of the kingdom, what God has promised in faith, it is by faith you are able to take delivery of it. Without faith, you cannot take it. Faith is the currency of the kingdom of God. So it is by faith. Faith is very powerful. It has spiritual force. And faith also is a mystery. It's a mystery. And that is why the Bible mentions in 1 Timothy 3, verse 9, it says we should hold faith in a pure conscience. That is the holy heart, which will hold faith, which will hold up to faith. Faith is what you must hold. And faith is difficult, it's complex to understand. It's difficult. And that is why you see the Bible. To define faith, to explain faith, is hard. If you go to Hebrew 11, verse 1, what happened to define faith? It's now faith in substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. I don't understand that. What do you mean by that? Now, faith is substance of things hoped for, evidence of things not seen. What is he talking about? If you are not spiritual, you don't even know what the Bible is talking about. You see, this is Hebrew 11, verse 1. So you think it's a spiritual person, somebody with illumination, revelation, God will open your eyes to be able to understand what faith is. And I follow the Bible because the Bible knows that faith is complex, faith is difficult to explain. Rather, it is easier to describe, to give example. And that's what you see Hebrew 11, from number 2 up to 40. Examples, examples of faith, examples, we're describing faith. They define faith in Hebrew 1, and from 2, they give you examples of faith. You see, by faith, Abraham has obtained the law. By faith, Abraham will act. By faith, true faith, by faith, true faith, by faith. So, they are telling you this faith, they used to obey all this money. And you, it's like God said, that man, he built that mansion with money. It is money used to build that mansion. The only one that bought that man, it is money used to buy that man. You know, he used money to buy that. He used money to buy it. He used money to build it. You know, the very good one is money. You see, he bought it with 10,000 naira. He bought this with 100. He bought this with 1 million, 2 million, 10 million. He had described it. By faith is how. True faith is how. This way. So people wonder, what is this faith? What is this faith? That all these people, true faith, they will be able to get what they got from God. And those that did not apply faith with their belief, God said they will not enter into his rest. They perish. Anyone that did not apply belief. What does that mean? There are Christians, people that believe God, Then because they did not mix it with faith, they become casual. Those people that died in the wilderness, were they not chosen? Is it not God that saved them from Egypt? They were chosen people of God. They were saved from Egypt. They passed through the Red Sea and to where they went. Did they believe God when they left Egypt? They have believed God. Did you believe God? They believed God. Even if you don't believe, after they take you to Red Sea, that great man and the old Egyptian, the Egyptian that was in the church, who do you believe? They won't have on the way. Gradually, they begin to doubt. They begin to doubt this is their God. This God, they begin to doubt. And that's why James, made it clear, James 1. Is it without faith that any that if you are doubtful, you don't think you can receive anything from God? James 1 verse 5 says. He says, then you allow yourself to let him ask. Let him ask of God and give him now. He said that if you ask in faith, you will get it. But if you doubt, let God that person think you will receive anything. That is like a way to deceive that way. So you see, two people must not doubt. And that is why you must not doubt the divine generosity. Now, faith, like I said, is complex. It's difficult. So, we want to look at how to overcome the enemies of faith. Are there enemies of faith? Yes, there are serious enemies of faith. Serious enemies of faith. There are serious enemies of faith. We have three major enemies of faith. Number one, set them together. You can write them down. Number one is Satan the devil and his cause. Satan the devil and his cause. They are the number one enemies of faith. They will do anything to attack your belief, to make you not to believe. But even if you believe, they will attack you so much, such that that your belief will not meet your faith. You begin to doubt, you will fight you seriously. So, Satan, devil, and his court, he has many of his children. He has children, them that with people that are angels, people that work for him in the marine kingdom, in the air, in so many places, principalities, powers. They are so many. They work for him. If you go to 2 Corinthians 4, verse 4, you see there Ephesians 2:2. He says, God of this world, the prince of the air, when they say a thing, they declare it to the world. Strong territorial devils. That is number one thing. Number two enemy is wrong mindset / mentality. Say wrong mindset.
Wrong mindset.
And mentality. Many people, their greatest undoing is their mindset. It is difficult for them to change their mindset. Even when they become Christian. Thank God they left the man from unbeliever. They became a believer. They became the alliance. Now, how do they become a Christian? Their mindset has not changed. They still have that mindset. You may want to say how? It's just like somebody that is a traditionalist. Somebody that grew up in the village. I don't know whether you met somebody that like custom and tradition. They cannot change. The person cannot bear. The person like custom and tradition. So that is how they were doing it. That is how it must be now. The person is not pragmatic. He's not believing that things are changing. They look at, they tell you Christianity, that is the worst religion. The missionary that came, what about our local church? What about our teacher? What about our Christian that we served before? The Ogu, the Shadow, they did not look at our chief. Those shrine, those things we had done before this white people brought Christianity. If you hear some people from the church, look at them. They say they want to deceive you within their Christianity. How? And the person wants to start fasting. The person mind will not change. That person will start to crash. You now a Christian. But his mindset has not changed. When you go into a discussion with a person, you will see his mindset is difficult for him. Because his mindset is rooted on that old church, that old dogma, that thing that you've told him that he has heard, somebody has seen. And that's the problem. Wrong mindset. As it's affecting a lot of people today. Even in Nigeria, so many people have wrong mentality. When you hear people speak, when you get them talk, you know this person has a mentality problem. You see some people, they hate government so much. They can start government with that if you give them. They say, Kai, government at them, this Nigerian government, this country, this government, this government, and some child out of this country. When they go to other country now, they see the same problem happening there too. This is still going on in this country too. This government, they begin to attack that government. Is it the government that is the problem? Is it the government that is the problem? It's not the government. Government is not the problem. I was telling one man that came to preach to me, I said, he said, look, I got the problem, if only the government can do well. I said, why do you want the government to do well? Did the Bible say the government will do well? He said, eh? He said, what did you say? I said, why should the government do well? He said, well, if only they can do the right. I said, but they cannot do the right. You want them to do the right. They can't do the right. That is what the Bible said. They will not do the right. So why do you want them to do the right? He said, but why are that problem they are doing the right? I said, who said all that problem are doing the right? Have you gone there? Do you know the problem they have? So you say Chinese, China, they are doing the right because they have the right approaches. You can tell you the same God. Say, what about Japan? What about Chinese? Ask them what religion they have. Ask them. You didn't say what in China has a God. Very few Christians. You see? But you see, they are developing. Who said the devil and God will not develop? Huh? The kingdom of this world, who tell you not develop? Then you see in Isaiah 45, he said, I will give you the hidden riches of darkness. I will transfer it to you. The other kingdom has somewhat well. And that is the way they used to deceive people. You understand? They used to deceive people. Say they will give you great riches. But you don't know that you have your kingdom now far more than that in the man Jesus. And even the one they have belongs to God. God owns everything. So you see, our greatest problem, mindset, is a serious problem. Then the last one is the world. The world itself and the people in the world. This is what was expressed in Isaiah. In the book of Isaiah 61 and 2. It says, our light and shine, the light is come. Darkness will cover the earth and cause darkness to the people. He's telling you that darkness will cover the earth. The earth will be full of darkness. That is saying, evil doing will be what will take over the world. Look at it. Then the people of the world, evil will dominate, sin will dominate. So many few people say, arise and shine, light is come. So it's those that are selected by the nation of grace that will arise. So you are in a society where dominated by evil doers, by unbelievers. So you see, that is a challenge. This is still a major issue. They are the enemies. They are the enemies. You must overcome this fear. That of the devil, yourself, and the people. Now tell me how you do it. That of the devil, and you fight the devil. Can you fight the devil by yourself? If you know how powerful the devil is, can you fight it by yourself? You cannot fight it by yourself. What about your goal, your mindset? Can you change your mindset by yourself? You cannot change your mindset by yourself. Can you, the people in the world, can you change them? They cannot change them. So you see, they see when they are quiet. It's a difficult situation. It's a very difficult situation. And this is what the Bible tells us in Ephesians. He said, we wrestle not against what? Flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers. saying, no, so thing must be like this, must be like this, must be like this. You cannot do otherwise. It's even in Christ. If not Jesus Christ, you cannot. If not Jesus Christ. It's only Jesus Christ that can help us. Why? You're not here. And you ask yourself, how did the enemy overcome? How did the angels overcome? Is it not Jesus Christ that helped them too? In Revelation 12, we saw it there. They were here by the blood of the Lamb and by the word of the testimony. And they loved not their life unto death. That was how they were able to do. So we can say, well, we're going to overcome it. I can not Jesus. But tonight, we are looking at the enemies of faith. I've got given you three enemies of faith. Now, let me tell you a secret about faith. Faith, you know, it's complex. It will be fine. It's complex. But we understand that faith has eight ingredients. If you want to cook faith, like if faith is a good system or tolerance, you see, my faith is impossible to define. If they say define a relationship, now how do you define it? Or define Jehovah's? How do you define it? That is what faith is about. Say you define a relationship. You see, if you did not define, but you can describe a relationship. You can describe a relationship. It is easy to describe a relationship. So you see, now there are ingredients of faith. Just like a relationship, they have the ingredients of a relationship. So if you know the ingredients, the makeup, what you put together that make up a relationship, the same way, what are the components of faith? And we know this church, we are familiar with it. There are eight ingredients of faith. Number one is what? Now. We say now is the word. Number two, substance. Number three is what? Hope. Number four, no evidence. Number five, believe. Number six, trust. Number seven, knowledge. Number eight, Jesus Christ. These are the eight ingredients of faith. They must combine together for you to cook a good faith. If you want to cook a good faith, a solid faith soup, this thing must be together. If it's not there, there is problem. If you believe and yet there is no trust, with the faith, what? The faith is unbelievable. Are you getting it? God said we should trust him. He said that I believe and do not trust God. Huh? I believe and I do not trust God. If a man, if somebody there is a man, this man, do you believe and say, I believe and I don't trust him. This man, you have no trust. Somebody who don't trust, you don't have confidence in the person. You don't hope about the person. I believe and I don't trust him. This is why I don't trust this person. So you see, so the faith is amputated. The ingredients, one thing is called the faith is a human being, one of the legs is cut off. So the eight ingredients must stay. Now, once you have these eight ingredients, you must make sure you are able to prepare a new faith. So you see now, we understand what is faith. Faith, these eight ingredients must be intact for faith to be good. Are you getting it? For you to have faith, these eight ingredients must be intact in my eight matches. Now, another secret about faith, which the enemy uses to deal with us. Faith, there are three things you must understand. Please get it here. There are three things you must know about faith. Number one is understanding faith. There is need for you to learn how to understand faith. Like I just gave you now, the 18 minutes of faith. You must know faith in total. You must know faith very well. Not small. You must know faith very well. Number one is understanding of faith. Number two is speaking faith. Number three is doing faith. I said number one, you must understand faith completely. Number two, you must know how to speak faith. Number three, you must know how to do faith. What is the doing faith? Now, this the reasons I'm saying? Doing faith is more difficult than speaking faith. Speaking faith is easy than doing faith. And speaking faith is more difficult than understanding faith. Speaking faith is more difficult than understanding faith. We need to be attentive to understand this. We have understanding faith, we have speaking faith, and we have doing faith. Now, there are people today, they speak faith. Bless you, they speak all the right things you want them to say, they speak. Some people, some things they don't understand, they still speak. They don't even understand it, they speak. All of them speak it. I don't hear bless you. Now, don't bless you. Don't even know where blessing is coming from. You don't know the history of blessing. You just, they are talking bless you. Like, you wake up, they say, good morning, join the good morning. You don't know what's good morning. Everybody say, good morning. Huh? How does good morning, where did it start from? You see? So that's how it is with speaking for you. Because now, people now, the doing faith is the hard part. A lot of people, they speak it, they cannot do it. They speak it, they cannot do it. It's just like somebody who talks about the uses well, or jollof rice well. Then to come and cook the jollof rice, you cannot do it, you cannot. Or somebody that talks about football, you see, he's very passionate about it, but he cannot play. He talks about it. Arsenal is my United. This is the best. Come and play. They will not be good. Are you saying? Then he talks about it. So now it is important we understand it very well. Is it not that good on your body? Is it not escort? If you don't have understanding of faith, you will not be able to apply it correctly. You hear that wisdom is profitable to direct. But when you have wisdom and it does not direct you profitable, or you don't even have wisdom, and wisdom did not direct you profitable. It's in the Bible. It said a wise man saved a city, but he was not recognized. Imagine. There was a small city, and enemies were about to come and attack that city. He said, one wise man there was able to get them what to do for the city to be saved. And the wise man told them, and the city was saved. Now, he said that wise man was not recognized. That the wise man was not rewarded. Just as he said that a poor man's wisdom is despised by his neighbor. If you are poor, you want to advise somebody, look at him and say, you give me advice. Go ahead yourself first. Why do you think that? I'm using a chief. I'm living in my own house. You are a tenant. And you are coming to advise me. What? How can I give you advice? You don't have a hand. You are using your leg. That is true that you are advising. Go and advise yourself, first of all. So you see, because the man is poor, a rich man cannot listen to that kind of person. You say you are sinful. You say the vision is for yourself. Not for me. Is there the vision that has made you the way you are? That kind of vision, I don't want that kind of vision. You don't know what people face when they go to preach. When a poor man goes to preach, that is the way you are. Huh? When God has decorated you, you don't need to say much. You don't say, come. You should not be that false. Is there the last day? You'll be a city of God. People will rush you. They will rush. They will say, please show me your God. They are the one who can tell you, say, please show me that you want to go. I want to go to you. They don't need to say much. Because you can see the blessing itself. Then you will see how this man went to the old king, the king of Judah. He went to meet the this person. He said, we go for this with you. We can see that you are better than some. He said, but our God, let's go for it so that you don't destroy us. It's coming to me, I think. When God bless you, the neighboring nation will begin to respect you, will begin to Yeah. So you see, now I'm teaching something. I'm telling you, understanding faith, speaking faith, and doing faith. Now this three things, if you are able to do it, your faith will go far. It will be very natural. But the enemy will attack. Enemy will attack your understanding. They will also attack your speaking, the ability to speak. They will even attack your doing faith. Every stage will be attacked. The enemy will attack. First of all, doesn't want to understand faith. Faith is a mission. You will not want to understand faith. Because if you have the understanding of faith, John 28 will be saved. He said, wisdom. He said, the fear of God is what? Wisdom. And to depart from evil is what? Understanding. A man that fears God that does not depart from evil will never have understanding. Listen to me. The fear of God is wisdom. To depart from evil is understanding. Now you see a man that fears God, but he refuses to depart from evil. You do not have understanding. The man does not have understanding. But he doesn't have wisdom. You say, I fear God. Leave evil. No more man feeling evil. When I talk of people speaking faith, you don't understand. You will see a brother, a sister. He's the one telling all that. Say, look, fornication is bad. Adultery is not good. This is bad. Confession is bad. But by the time you leave there, you tell the one fornication. Do you see that brother have understanding? He does not understand. But he's speaking it to people. He's telling people, he's preaching something, and himself is going to be modernized. That person does not have understanding. But when you hear him talk, when you hear him speak, he's saying all the right thing. He's speaking fit. Are you ready? He's speaking fit when he hears it. Yes. This man is speaking fit. He's saying all the things. But he's saying it in error. Why is he saying it in error? He does not do it. He will not. After he leaves, he will not commit adultery. After he leaves, he will not commit fornication. After he leaves, he will not sin. All the things he has said, no. Maybe we are talking about adultery. Let's go there. Now, this man is saying, this day is my year of peace. This day is my year of peace. And when he goes, he has declared it. He leaves the church and gets home. And Lord comes and pray your rent. He said, hey, what do I do with you? This time. Hey, Lord, I don't get any money. I don't. Say, please, I don't. Lord said, bad, if you don't pay me, you cannot do it. Say, please, I don't. Lord, I don't know. He said, how do you do this situation of finance? How? No more. All the faith you ask, you are the small faith of church. You are not saying you are saying no money. How are we going to do it? As you are saying no money, the agent will say, correct. Correct, no money. No money, I bet you no money is going to be. You are saying all right. Are you saying? You spoke faith. You prayed about faith. People hear you. I remember that. But now look at you now. The time for action now. Are you saying? This week, before Friday, I'm coming. I'm expecting my money now. He said, this is the way you talk to my landlord. In confidence, look at him in his face. The landlord think there is money actually now. And you know that there is no money coming. Now, this week, I'm telling you, before Friday. He said, and I'm going to say, see the devil before Friday. Let me go. I will pay a guy Friday or start to make money. He said, no problem, you'll get it. The landlord goes. Then he said, ah, fine. I don't understand. The two dogs will have peace. This man that came from is not the man of peace. The man is the man of trouble. When he has found peace to him, he has said, you have what I said. This is of peace. Please provide this money. Provide this money for me. You begin to say what you'll be sure of how God will do it. Before Wednesday, before that money will come, how do you do the money? We will face a serious situation. By some of these stories that we have house, we have this and all that, we don't know what's going on. Myself and my wife, we are faced with serious rejection problem. Gambler Street. The number 6 and all of that, one house there. And they came, they said, within 3 days, we'll back up. What did you do? And all the things people were suggesting, they don't know they have uncompleted rooms of the way you are just buying. They are the only thing, the windows don't complete, we use cloth to cover it. We didn't have any money, no savings, nothing. First, serious objection. 3 days. So what happened? And as they are bringing different ideas to me, we'll be thinking them. Not that we went to check this. And we saw this is whatever you see today and whatever. There are many houses, you don't see many houses, goat and sheep are the one living there. There will be bigger. So you just want me one big guy, one big one. He said, they look anywhere where you're going. He said, well, you don't do this one more. He said, back enter, enter. Then go down the window, for night, then you come beat you there. You'll be praying that God, let the thief come and beat you inside the place. As you are coming, you see people putting their clothes, different things, it's not there. People are living there. Some are there for some food. So myself and my wife, we went to check out. So this one, go back here, come on, come on, come on, come. We need that. We made that we move up. Baby, I was annoyed in this place. I wasn't. So it has gone to this one. That we live this day, it is this one we never do not last. What is this? I went to meet one that was in charge of the house. I have been meeting him and talking to him about the house. But that day, when I met him, was a different way I spoke to him. I said, it is his name is a different. And the senior school. Please, I need the house. I beg. Now, myself, I have to do the job. So, why? I said, you will be in the house. You are in charge of business. Sorry, talk about it. He said, you know your reference. He said, you know your reference. He said, you know how all the places are over. He said, there's this new house that is completed at Guadalajara. Can you stay in Guadalajara? It's far. He said, Catabura Estate. They said, look, people, in the US, they if you don't get that, I said, well, I said, well, the way my situation is, even if it's local jail, I'm ready to go.
Thank you.
Let the prophet walk. Let the prophet walk.
Yes,
that you may mention the exact wanting mountain. Now, you focus. When they don't mention that, you might not understand very well. When you go to Revelation 3, verse 10, read Revelation 3, verse 10, you will see what the patient is doing. When I say patient, what are you doing? You're patient on. Is it patient on one man, or patient on yourself, or patient? See what you have to patient on. Revelation 3, 10.
Kept the word of my patience.
You see, because thou hast kept the word of my patience. What did God say? Are you getting it?
I also will keep thee from the hour of temptation.
I also will keep you from the hour of temptation.
Which shall come upon all the world.
Which shall come upon all the world.
To try them that dwell upon the earth.
Thank you very much. You see, so you have to know that your patience will be on the word that God said. And God sent it. This will be showing other lives. You refuse. You refuse. We pray God for some Sunday divine in the name of Jesus. Today is Wednesday. I still have a problem to teach, but I don't think we'll be able to do it. Yeah? It is so much things to teach. And I'm going to scratch this on it. So let's leave it for someone to do. So that we don't go wrong. We don't rush. Let's leave it for someone. There's someone who needs to understand you. Who are not the enemy. Because this enemy, they are serious enemy. They are not a warfare on you. They are serious enemy. You need to know their strategy. We need to know how to operate. So when you know how to operate, they will deal with it. They say, no, that you want your advantage. And you want export. When you see men of faith, something they know, when they see this and all of that, they train their mind. They train their mind not to see what is happening. Eh? You see what they say? Jesus don't judge by sight. Are you getting it? It is faith. If you go to Isaiah 11, we'll be telling you that Jesus will not judge by sight. He will guide his lion. Eh? He will guide his law with righteousness. He will guide his heart, his name, with faithfulness. All those things, we are going to see them on Sunday. Let me explain it so that you understand how it works, the practicality, how it works. So when you understand, when it deals with the heart of the government, you say, this is a test of it. This is a test of it. This is a test of it. So you know. Because we try. We understand every trial and tribulation that comes, every temptation, is not of God. God does not tempt any person to evil. And no man can tell God to leave. Every temptation that you see that you come across is as a result of your lust. As a result of what you believe, what you are perfecting, what you must suffer. The enemy will not tempt you in what you don't like. He looks at you. This one likes it. He goes to the area that you like. What you have need for, what you are challenging. If you don't like your somebody that doesn't like fashion, doesn't like clothes, it will not tempt you to do it. Because if you're clothes, I'm not interested. If there are food you like your job, chicken bone, it's got beans and all that, he will tempt you with that. He knows you like all those things. So he looks at you and knows what you like. If you are a man that likes women, your temptation will be more. If you are a man, whatever you like, so he looks at you, he knows what. So every one of us will know ourselves. We know what we desire. We know what we are looking for. So those are the things we want to tempt you with. But if you have understanding, you will pass it. You will never go back home. But when you don't have understanding, you will fall. So you see, everyone is tempted by his loss. And when your loss conceive, it will conceive and become pregnant with sin. And when that sin is fully mature, it will bring what? Death. That's why the wages of sin is death. The wages of lust is what? Sin. Everyone that lost it will fall. So that's something like a man that does not have time is not to. What do you want to tell? You carry brand new car, say, I did. That's good. You will not tell you, say, I cash you, make that day. The brand new car you get is that you give it and another person. You feel that? So, you are giving it out. Okay, let me give you a horse. Did you like us?